What is happening, ladies and gents? Slaymate here, playing some of the Dwarves. The Dwarves! I don't know if I can roll any more R's. The Dwarves. Anyways, it's a tactical turn-based murder fest where you play as a bunch of dwarves. What? No. And you queue up all their moves in unison, you know, standard turn-based type action. And let's just hop in and give it a go. I don't know if it's gonna restart me. I did a little bit in order to brand new. All right.
To protect Gardelgard.
Gardelgard.
Against orcs, ogres, and all the other beasts of Tior.
Ogres.
We are the guardians of Gardelgard. We are the children of the divine smith. We are the dwarves.
The end. Oh, good game. We learned that they're dwarves, and they fight for smithing gods. All right, tutorial time. Pause the game. Paused it. How do you like them apples? All right, so we run over here.
All right.
And I can pause it, cue up what I want to do. Let's just jump onto these dudes, including my own men. Splat! Friendly fire, by the way. If they're down, I think you get one shot. Okay, even when they're getting up, nice. So we got these little blue pips underneath our health bar, and those are what we use to do our moves. We've got a push move where we charge through stuff. We've got a cleave-looking thing. Knocks out your backs. We've got our jump. The jump seems pretty OP. Land on dudes and then kill them while they're down, you know? Splat.
Come here, you. Stay
there. Music seems like it might be just a wee bit loud. Maybe it's just me, but, you know. We knock anybody else down. That guy's stunned. Just cleave. Or slam, ground slam. Jumping on more dudes. That guy got knocked down. So he got murdered. You know what? I'm just gonna jump on more dudes. How about them apples? One shot those down guys. That guy is not down. I do not have any more pips. There we go. I'll just auto attack that guy to death. Nice. Let's jump again. Knock down. Who was it?
On my way.
Somebody got knocked down. That guy. Get over there, you. Nice. Hurt splat. Nobody knocked down.
Come here, you.
Oh no, that guy did. Splat. Double splat. Eat a bag of these dwarven nuts.
Come here, you.
I like killing the guys that get down. That is cute. So far, my favorite move. Splat. Are you down? No. Are you down? Maybe. No. Alright, what do we want to do? Let's try the charge just to see what it does. Okay. Threw me into harm's way. That's bad.
Come here, you! A present from the workshop.
Eh? Go over to the chest and click on his. Use users. Alright. Can you get over there, sir? Charge to it. That did not work. There are way too many dudes. I can't get through. That charge was a bad choice. Come on. Just get an auto attack, you son of a... Okay. There we go. We got through.
I'd be happy to pass on this present to the Greenskins.
The Greenskins. What do we got? We've got the bombs. All right. Oh.
That's that?
Wow, okay. Can I turn the camera? I sure can. All right. I don't know why I would want to, but that is many dudes. Oh, we've got a bunch of bombs. Oh my god. Sploop. Wait for him to group back up, maybe. Give him a little sploop again. Nice. Maybe another sploop. Oh my god. Okay. Still a lot of dudes. Jeez. Something tells me this is a battle that we cannot win. Should I blow up my own guys? I think I should. Sploop.
My king! What are you doing here?
Gizelbert I and I, the father of the Fifthling clan, has not been on the front line of battle against the creatures of Teon for many cycles. The king surveys the battlefield and the defenders.
Maybe I'll turn the volume back up.
We are too few.
This you know as well as he does. But there will be no reinforcements arriving. Hundreds of brave warriors lie inside the fortress dying. The illness is running rampant. It brings weakness.
The illness?
Stay at your posts. Be as steadfast as the granite of which we are made. Nothing can break us. Vrakas is with us.
For the horde. Change between characters at the bottom of the ding ding dong. Nice. Okay.
On
the way. Well, let's, you know. Obama, do nice. Good job. Okay. What do we get? He's got a buff, a stun, and a cleave. Okay. All right. It's not bad.
What is it?
Another bomb? Might as well. That's all right. And then let's jump onto some dudes. Probably bad to be out here in the group, but you know. Go on this guy, I guess. Splat. Yeah, just auto attack some dudes. Actually, that guy's down. Get a one-shot on him. Oh, it kind of worked. Let's see. Nah, we'll cleave again. Oh, all right. Did that guy get flown over?
Yes.
No, apparently he did.
Just a moment.
Knocked down like a little bee. Should we focus on these guys? Probably should. They brought a cave troll. Should I jump on the dudes? Sploop. One down. All of them to go. Oh my god, I think I cleaved myself. Probably a bad idea. How can I push such a giant man?
What?
Thing. Ogre. Ogre. Hot ogre action. You know what? Let's heal. Nice. Push our way through, men. Push it through. For the dwarven kind. Can we throw dudes off the edge?
Another
We totally can. Nice. I'll get over there. You totally can. Get over there now. Get. No, it's too many dudes. All right, well, time to cleave. Oh, snaps. Okay, that doesn't really do too much. We'll just get our slap on until we get our jump. There we go. What? And we go up for the knockdowns. Excuse me, sirs? How do I see their health bars? I wanna see the health bars all the time.
What is it?
Nice. Oh yeah, look at all those guys get chucked out. Did I throw off my own man? I did. Whoops. Whoops-a-doodle. Well, my dwarf people aren't gonna like me. Get in there, you. For Vrakus, apparently. You got it, buddy. Get in there. Get in there. Heal everybody, maybe. And a little stun action. Kill that guy. Yes. Kill all of the downed men. Gruesome. Yep.
Charge.
Focus on this catapult. Mm, 900 damage for a little ground slamming action. Pretty nice. Probably not worth, but you know. Just get off me, okay? Uh-oh. Whoops. Let's fight side by side. Hurt! Cleave my king.
Yes.
Nice.
What is it?
Get over there. Go on. You can do it. Gross. There you go. Does it count?
Yes.
Get away. Yeah, his is kind of not great. Not as good as the King's Cleave. It's only 300, though. Definitely should use the other one.
These are the ones who attacked us in the tunnels. We suffered great losses beating them back.
Great to meet you.
Come here and I'll split you like a straw, you treacherous elf!
Look at all that gas on the bridge.
The old king radiates a ferocious power that none of Sitalia's children could withstand. But the slight, willowy being sitting astride the shadow mare just grins down.
That elf is farting his way along the bridge, it looks like.
We are Alpha. We are here to destroy the elves.
All peace-loving beings here in Girdlegard are under our protection, and you cannot open the gate that has barred your path into Girdlegard since the creation of the world.
Not us, but perhaps one of your kind.
No!
This cannot be. Silence, you fool! Vrakus, forgive me for what I am about to do.
Too late.
Quickly! In formation! You must hold them back until I close the gate! What is it?
Ah, balls. Just keep slamming them. I should have jump stunned. Oh, God. Hurt! Everybody knock down. Kill the knockdowns. Yeah. Who else?
On the way.
Can't quite tell.
Charge!
Let's get in on this action. Stomping! Knockdown, yeah! Double knockdown, yeah! Triple knockdown! Still got it, nice. Sploop! Get wrecked. Hit, sploop! Splat them all. No, not that guy, this guy. Nice. Hit, sploop! For the sploop! Splat! Get off me, king! Nice. No! Arrowed! No! No. Guess we're not playing as those guys.
Look at me. I am Syntharas, the reaper of your death. I will take your life, and the land will take your soul.
Get out and of then I'll take your anus.
Pointy ears. And let me delight at the closed gate a little longer. The gate may have closed, but when you rise again from the dead by the power of the land, you will be one of us, and you will open it.
No.
Never.
My soul belongs to Rakas. No. Your soul now belongs to the land, and henceforth you will belong to it forever. Now die. And return. Then hand us Girdleguard.
Oh, pushed it right through that armor. That's pretty tough.
Squirtleguard. The best Pokemon.
Excuse me? 1.35 cycles later. Sweet eyebrow piercing.
You're a perfectionist, Tung Del Bolivar.
That's it, you're
I've got a reputation to uphold. If you can't rely on the metalwork of a dwarf, what can you rely on?
Oh, I gotta choose what I say? What? You look dreadful! I mean, you look dreadful!
Dreadful?
What a charmer.
Yeah.
Blade gives you an ironic reprimanding scowl.
Ikana has been crying half the night.
When you were teething,
your husband
the vaults.
Cries
you
after sex,
my
huh? Interesting.
Sang you to sleep.
Frala smiles. She's heard this story many times before.
That was 23 cycles ago. I'm quite sure you didn't sing. You might have grumbled a bit.
If what you've read about the dwarven lifespan is true, it'll be another 300 sun cycles or more before you are called to the Eternal Forge. The certainty of one day having to witness Frala's death already burdens your heart.
But also arouses you. I mean, what can I do for you?
For me, nothing. It's Lot Yonan. He wants to see you in his study.
Bah.
In your mind, you go through all the recent incidents that might have annoyed the Magus. Apart from a few little squabbles with his famuli, nothing worth mentioning happened since the incident with your beard. You nod.
Okay. I better not keep the Magus waiting.
See you later. There's goulash for dinner.
Delicious. Delicious goulash.
There was a time when you could hardly lift the heavy hammer. Now you barely.
That was last Thursday.
And it feels like an extension of your arm.
Excuse
Smithing
me?
Is in your blood.
Something added to my inventory? Trailer amulet. What do I do with it? Throw it in the trash?
This is where you swung the forge hammer for the first time. 30 cycles ago. No one taught you the craft. It was enough for you to watch Lot Yonan's old smith at work. Whenever the workshop was empty,
yeah.
You
watch
practiced
that old smith at work.
And mastered the craft with ease.
Oh, hey there. You gotta take the axe. Yeah, just like Grandma taught you. What else we got? We got stuff in our bedroom, it looks like.
Everything you know about dwarves you learnt from books. The divine smith created the dwarves, and from time to time you make him an offering of some crumbs of gold.
Golden
crumbs? It's the most valuable thing you have to offer Vrakus. You've worked a bit more on Sunya's birthday present last night. The little one is crazy about horses. You, on the other hand, prefer to keep your distance unless you're fitting them with hooves. Too many legs and way too big.
Yeah. Some people call me a horse, you know what I'm saying? I don't know why.
There are apparently dwarves who have never seen the sky. And you too feel more comfortable when you have rock over your head. If only you didn't long to see more of the world, a longing that grows stronger with every year.
I love strong yearnings.
Hey, groundling! Come to the kitchen, we need you.
Jollison, a fourth-degree famulus and your favorite foe among the students of magic, gives you a disparaging glance and disappears without waiting for your reply.
Yeah, he seems like a doucher. He ran this way, though. There he is.
Tattletale! Quick! Or the goulash will get burnt!
You immediately recognize what the problem is. A chain running over a pulley for positioning the cauldron is detached from its mounting, and the cauldron stuck in the fireplace.
No, my God.
It's a heavy load, and none of the family who feel superior even during kitchen duty dare do anything. They might burn their fingers, or even get a bit dirty.
I love them a bit dirty. Oh, let's just grab it then, with our hands.
Sears the flesh off your hands.
A waste of goulash. And I'm hungry. Here, hold this.
Let's examine the mounting bracket
with
thoroughly.
With as much concern in your voice as you can muster, you say,
oh, no, no, this doesn't look good.
You're pleased to notice he's dripping with sweat.
Ooh, look at him glisten.
I'll get you back for this, groundling!
Let's talk to him.
Do you remember when you dyed my beard with some magic spell? I had to shave it off.
You stroke your beard, which is unusually short for a dwarf.
Damn it! Ah, it's heavy!
The young human forces through his pursed lips, letting the pot sink a little.
Don't you dare ruin my goulash, boy!
The cook with beefy forearms glares at the young man, and after a brief moment, he tries harder.
I'll repair it.
You damned freak!
For a moment, you hope the famulus really does raise his hand to you. But then he comes to his senses and leaves the kitchen, his face bright red.
What a pair you are!
Yeah, we'll bang later. That's cool.
The goulash is bubbling in the cauldron. You draw the warm air in through your nose, and the smell makes your mouth start watering.
Ooh. Why is this game so erotic?
I am your godfather, little one. I'll look after you just like I looked after your mother.
Little Akana grasps your calloused finger and smiles at you wide-eyed.
Okay. Let's get some food.
Vegetables, bread, cheese, but the cook taters. Is not to be trifled with. Many painful knuckles have taught you that she knows how to handle her heavy wooden spoon, and that she may possibly have eyes in the back of her head.
She's shucking something? What's going on over here?
Do you know what Loyonan wants?
The maid gives you an amused look. She has often accused you of making things more complicated than necessary.
That was it? I'll murder you.
Do you know what Loyonan...
The beer that is delivered to the vaults is supposed to be the best beer in Iddeslane. It's certainly your favorite beer. But you haven't drunk enough other beers to truly know.
That is, like, the biggest shame of all for a dwarf. Ooh, what you got?
The blacksmith. Do you want something?
Did a horse bolt while you were trying to shoe it? It's certainly not on our plates.
Pilfer some food. Give me that sandwich. Oh, yeah. Oh, 25 XP earned. Oh, God. You guys got some food for me? Give me.
Hey,
Hey, what are you doing, groundling?
I'm hungies.
We're still eating here. Why don't you go and get your own portion?
Why don't you go to my room and get ready for a sweet
Of the 200
food
or so
time.
People selected to learn the art of magic under Lot Yonan, there's barely a handful of them you can stand the sight of. You're not at all interested in magic in all its elusiveness and whimsy. Your realm is the Forge. Lot Yonan's vaults are equipped with laboratories, a library, and private rooms for the famuli. Together with the forge, the kitchen, and the other utility rooms, it makes up quite an impressive complex. But compared to the courts of the other Magi, the seat of power in Yonandar is small and modest.
Just like your penis. Look at the bookcase. Do it!
Lot Yonan didn't just take you in. He also taught you how to read and write.
Big mistake.
But you don't feel like reading right now. Especially as you already know all the books by heart.
Master Lot Yonan, Frala told me you wish to speak with me.
Ah, Tungil, come in.
There is Tungil.
A bag over there in the cupboard. Take it out, please. It contains artifacts belonging to my former famulus Goren. I wish to return them to him. He's in Black Saddle, 300 miles away.
300 miles? That's a long journey. Who are you going to entrust with this?
I was thinking of you.
Me?
There is no one better to take on this journey. You have acquired much knowledge. You are almost a scholar. You know more than most famuli about Girdlegard and its inhabitants. It is time for you to go out into the world and see it with your own eyes.
I... with pleasure.
Just kiss him. What's in the pooch?
What's in the bag?
Magical devices. You better leave the bag closed if you want to avoid any accidents. Dwarves don't really like magic, and magic doesn't like you either.
That's just rude.
Rakkus gave us so much craftsmanship that there's no space left in our bodies for magic.
Strictly speaking, every time you've been too close to magic, it has ended in catastrophe.
Except for sexual magic in the bedroom.
Perhaps I'll meet some dwarves on my travels.
Yes, perhaps. But don't hold out too much hope. And be careful who you talk to. Not everyone out there likes dwarves.
Oh, come on. Everybody loves dwarves.
Yeah. Goblins. They abduct baby dwarves and sell them to magi, from what I've heard.
Not the best bit of business I've ever done. But what was I to do?
I should bring some
the
babies to trade along the way.
Throw you into the nearest river. Be on your guard. Look after the bag and don't lose it. May Palandiel be with you. And Varakas too, of course.
Of course.
I'll set off immediately. I'll see you soon, Lot Yonan.
Bag full of trash. Ooh, he gave me 200 bones. We've already done everything in there, I think. Say goodbye to our lady friend.
Hello, Frala.
Oh. I got a present for you.
A present for you.
It's in
you
my pants.
You take out a symbol of protection that you carefully made.
It was in his pants.
Horseshoe nails.
It's not the finest jewelry in Girdlegard.
One look at Frala's face makes it clear that it doesn't matter.
She hates it.
She glows with happiness as she takes the pendant.
For me? Why?
Because you don't see me as an oddity, and you're like a little sister to me.
Oh, sister zone.
But you settle with a shrug and a crooked smile.
I need provisions for 300 miles.
You're grinning from ear to ear. Finally, you've got the chance to see something of the world.
300? Tungdil, that's no errand. That's an epic journey. Wait, I've got just the right thing. But make sure the cook doesn't see.
I'll murder him. Settle to return a few things to a former apprentice in Amagus.
You pocket the rye bread, sausages, and ham. Enough food for the first few days of your journey.
That's not enough food.
Perhaps I'll even meet some dwarves on the way.
Frala throws you a cautious glance.
This doesn't seem like the game where you meet dwarves.
You can't help but broach.
There aren't dwarves down here. You're the only one in Ida's Lane, as far as we know.
I know, but I can't just have been born out of a rock. Somewhere in the mountains, I have a clan. Maybe even a family.
Yes. Maybe.
Frala has reminded you more than once that Lot Yonan wrote to the dwarf clans and none of them were missing a dwarf boy.
That's because you're a dwarf girl.
I've got a long journey ahead of me.
Can't tell them apart.
I wish you the blessing of Palandiel and Vrakas to protect you from all danger on your journey. Here, a talisman. Whenever you look
at
it,
she just regifted my thing back to me.
Frala winks at you mischievously.
And of getting me a nice present.
Oh, all right. What'd she give me? A scarf. Brings good fortune to the wearer? I doubt it. All right, see you later.
Within a few moments, you find Black Saddle on the map. It is southeast of Perista, a little more than halfway between the city of the Magus Nudin and Lot Yonan's vaults.
Whoa, a nudist camp.
You trace the path from the vaults to the mountain with your finger. It doesn't seem far on the map, but it will be the biggest journey of your life.
Nice. Let's do this.
I didn't even get a new jacket or anything. Forgot to bring a change of underwear for my whole trip.
How nice to see you again, Lot Yonan.
Ooh, it must have got been something on your face, bro.
Since we last met face to face.
Nudin, welcome. Please, sit down.
No, thank you, my friend. These are urgent matters, and I don't have much time. You must come to Leos Nudin immediately. The perished land is stirring.
Are you sure? What makes you think that?
I found out about 60 orbits ago, during a
visit
to the borders. Our magical barriers have weakened and become porous.
It's not the only thing that has something wrong with its pores.
And a huge horde of orcs have marched into Girdlegard.
Were you able to strengthen the spell with your magic?
No. I can't repair the damage alone. We need the combined power of the six. The other four are already on their way here, but we need your help too.
I will set off for Perista without delay.
Oh, and as you're coming, could you also take the opportunity to bring back the things that I lent to you?
No.
Of course. I have them already packed in a bag.
Oh, thank you. We'll be expecting you.
I think the game is afoot.
Utterly blinded by the sunlight, you squeeze your eyes tightly shut after only a few steps. The time spent underground has made you so sensitive to light that you're forced to seek shelter in the shade of a mighty oak.
So sensitive. Okay, now we get to, like, choose our path and choose our own adventure.
You reach a small lake by a birchwood. Your feet hurt and your eyes still sting.
It's only been 5 minutes.
Sunlight. But a smile spreads across your face nonetheless. You've covered a decent distance on the first day of your big journey. You pitch your camp and lie down to sleep
on
the
hard
forest floor.
You're that excited.
In the morning, your legs are stiff and achy.
That's not the only thing that's stiff.
Sorry for yourself. You throw your rucksack over your shoulder. You're a dwarf, and dwarves don't complain.
Really? All right, well, let's just get to go get a move on over here.
Around midday, with the sun high in the sky and the first beads of sweat appearing on your forehead, you see something move next to the road, a few hundred meters ahead. Some crows are pecking at something in the long grass.
Let's stand still and observe the scene.
You survey the grass, the bushes, and the few trees that are growing on both sides of the track. The wind blows through the grass, and the leaves tremble. The pecking of the birds is only interrupted by the occasional fluttering of their wings. Apart from that,
okay, so they're not afraid. Nothing. Nothing going on there. Let's leave the road and sneak up on the crows.
The creaking leather armor, the clattering rucksack, and a dwarf's inability to be quiet makes the crows flap around as you move from one bush to another. You give up trying to be stealthy, stand up straight, and see two human bodies in the flattened grass.
Oh. Oh, a dead body. Oh, someone's doing that dead body. Oh, what's up, dead body? What's up?
How's it going? A slender man lies in front of you.
Slenderman?
Dressed in an expensive robe. It is in the colors of Turgur the Fair-Faced, one of the six Magi. The dead man must be one of Turgur's famuli. You don't see any wounds.
I'm gonna turn this body over. Oh, yeah.
I've Rakus.
There are some narrow stab wounds in the man's chest. The cuts are too big to have been made by arrows, but too small for sword wounds.
That's terribly mysterious. Let's look at this one.
You look down on a tall, broadly built man. He's wearing dark brown leather armor that is strengthened with iron plates. There's a sword lying next to him. Was he trying to defend himself against something or someone? There is no blood on the sword.
He's wearing dark brown leather so that no one can see him shit his pants when he's scared.
The man has the same incisions. It's clear that both men were killed by the same weapon. But what that weapon might be, you cannot say.
Let's look at this rucksack.
A rucksack that probably belonged to one of the dead. It seems to have been searched and then thrown away carelessly.
Let's search it anyways.
You find a few implements, some provisions, and a map. A route is drawn on it from Perista, Nudin's capital, to Lotjonan's vaults.
Ooh. Does this mean that Turgur the Fair-Faced is in Perista and wanted to send Lotjonan a message? And if so, why didn't he use magic? Did he want to contact him without anyone noticing? Why all this secrecy?
The mysteries.
You don't see any signs of a struggle in the area where the corpses are lying. Were they stabbed by a companion? A stranger could hardly have crept up on them with such sparse cover.
Let's look at these bushes. Can we eat them?
Nothing.
Damn it, I want to eat the bushes.
Nothing again.
You halt. There is something.
Another rucksack?
Let's search it.
You open the rucksack and recognize that someone has already rummaged through it.
Damn it.
As well as some implements and writing utensils, you find a pouch full of gold and a talisman. The gold is proof that this is not a case of robbery.
Let's take the gold and the talisman.
Warmth and a feeling of security flush through your body as you touch the talisman. You feel safer just holding it in your hand.
I'm taking you with me.
XP earned. What was it? Talisman of Protection. Simple. When damage is received, there's a 50% chance of reducing the damage. Okay. I think I put it on. Yep, got my little face. Okay, whoa. Anything else? I don't see anything. What? The hell? Scour the area once more and ask yourself what to do next? Oh. Bury the dead and then continue on your journey? Sure. Why not?
It's time-consuming and strenuous work digging shallow graves in the ground with a stick and covering the corpses with a few stones. But it should at least keep the crows from their feasting for a while. You continue on your way so as to put a few more miles between you and your grisly find before night falls.
I wonder if we should go to all the points to try to get more XP. Oh, we got things moving in on us. Oh, I see. Every one we go to is a day. All right.
You see a flickering light through the trees some way from the path. It might come from a campfire.
Ooh. Approach the fire audibly so you don't frighten anyone. Okay.
You walk towards the fire with confident strides until you finally make out three broad-shouldered men with axes. Two rabbits are sizzling over the fire. The men are joking with one another, but you can only understand the odd word. They haven't noticed you yet.
I should throw a rock at one of their heads. No, let's approach them and talk to them.
Once you reach the edge of the firelight, you say amicably,
"Greetings. My name is..."
The men jump up and grab their axes.
"Who's there?"
"Well, I'll be. Is that a grandling?"
The men look you over suspiciously.
I'm a traveler and would have nothing against a warm fire and some company.
"My name is Tongdil. I'm only a traveler who would have nothing against a warm fire and some company."
"A groundling wants our company."
"We are honest, hard-working men. Why would we have anything to do with groundlings? Be off with you."
The man strengthens his grip on the axe and passes his tongue over his yellowed teeth. Ooh. While keeping you in his sights.
Yeah, he's licking his lips. Nice. I just have one question.
Sod off, groundling. Have I made myself clear?
The man comes a step closer.
Oh, okay. All right, I'll go if I'm not welcome here.
You shrug your shoulders indifferently and take three small steps backwards without taking your eyes off the men.
All right, if I'm not welcome here, then I'll go.
"Good. And don't even think about coming back to stab us in the back or steal from us. We'll keep guard. There's nothing here for groundling scum."
"I'm no thief and certainly no murderer. I just want to see why there was a fire burning."
Your heart is pounding, and you confront the man a little more courageously than you feel.
"I'm no thief, and I'm certainly no murderer. I only wanted to see if..."
"Pah! All groundlings are thieves and good-for-nothings."
You find it difficult to take control of your voice again.
"Have you met many dwarves?"
"Enough to know that you're all dirty thieves."
"I mean, that's true. Think about it, I'm a dwarf. I don't use my axe for chopping down trees."
"Now consider this. I am a dwarf with an axe, and I don't use my axe for cutting down trees."
The men are visibly unsettled and lower their axes.
That's right.
"I thought so."
You turn your back on the men and walk back to the path confidently. You don't hear any steps behind you, and only once you've put distance between you do you dare look back over your shoulder. None of the men have followed you. You sigh with relief. It could have ended up a very painful experience if you'd provoked the men or shown them any weakness.
50 XP earned, all right. Let's go to this little town thingy.
As the gable end of a small farmhouse and a barn appear from behind a hilltop, you hear the loud cries of children at play. A girl runs along the path laughing, followed by a small boy with a big stick in his hand.
Whoa.
The boy is trying to catch up his sister with a determined look on his face.
And hit her with a stick? That's terrible.
But it's difficult to keep his short legs under control on the uneven path.
Walk towards the children, greet them amicably.
You walk towards amicably. The children. As you raise your hand to greet them, the boy catches sight of you. His eyes grow wide, and he points to you with a chubby little finger. All he can manage to say is, "There." Now the girl has turned to face you too,
Before you can say a word, she lifts her little brother up into her arms and runs screaming.
Oh my god, she's like a man. Grabbing kids and running. Let's follow them to the farm. Nothing creepy about that.
Without rushing, you follow the children to the farmhouse into which they've disappeared. After a few moments, they reappear, accompanied by their parents. Their father is a thick-set man with grey hair.
I am Opatcha. This is my wife, Remsa.
The blonde woman nods a greeting almost imperceptibly and clasps her daughter tightly to her. She looks you over with an anxious expression.
It's a pleasure to meet you. My name is Tundle.
You try to make your voice sound as harmless as possible.
Have two travelers passed by here in the last few days?
Over the last few days, have you seen two travelers heading east?
Opatia looks at his wife, but she shakes her head.
Why do you ask?
I found them. Two dead bodies on the side of the road. A good day's march east from here.
Dead bodies?
She hastily covers her son's ears.
Was it orcs?
Remsa, what would orcs be doing up here? It was probably just bandits.
I'm sorry if I scared your wife and children.
The man waves dismissively.
No, no. It's just that my fair woman is especially jumpy these days.
The orcs have been spotted near Calmstead. You should take it more seriously.
The farmer's wife clutches her daughter even tighter before the girl finally protests. The boy steps forward excitedly and cuts the air with his stick.
If strangers come, we're supposed to run away, but I can hit them too.
Opatia pats his son on the head, laughing.
We're safe. The orcs have no reason to come so far north.
Wouldn't it be better to move to one of the bigger villages if there are orcs around?
The farm is our livelihood. We can't just leave the place. The fields don't look after themselves. King Tilligorn's cavalry will take care of the orcs. Or Lord Yonan and his magi.
But the cavalry can't be everywhere at once. Even a handful of orcs would be enough to finish us.
Once the seeds are planted, I'll build the hideaway, just as you wish. But what use is a hideaway if we've nothing to eat in the autumn?
Can eat the kids, dude. You should build the hideaway immediately, so you're safe.
If there are orcs in the area, then you shouldn't waste any time. Build that hideaway.
The dwarf is right.
Remsa gives you a thankful smile before turning to her husband.
We'll take care of the other problems when we come to them. The most important thing is... Eat the kids.
Opatia stays silent for a moment, a gloomy expression on his face, before shrugging his shoulders.
All right then. Dwarves do know best when it comes to orcs.
You bid farewell and set off on your way. The children follow you for a while, before saying their goodbyes in laughter and running back towards the farm.
And throwing an egg at the back of your head. Should I do a loop? So many days. All right.
You reach the banks of the Warder and can see Axeldale on the other side. But there isn't a bridge for far and wide. The fishermen's boats glide over the water, which sparkles in the sun. None of the men seem to notice you while they throw out their nets.
Oh, no men are noticing me. Feels bad. Let's view the scenery for a while.
You look at the cold, dark water. The current seems so strong that they could carry off even the most experienced of swimmers. And you aren't even a mediocre one. You once read a legend in a book. Elria, the goddess of water, did not like the children of the forge and cursed the dwarves so that they would drown in any waters beyond their kingdoms. The main reason that dwarves avoid water to this day.
Let's call to the nearest fisherman and ask him to take you across the river.
You call to the nearest fisherman. He looks across at you briefly before turning away and getting back to his work.
What an ass.
You're going to have to find another way of crossing
the
river.
I'm going to throw rocks into the river and scare away all the fish.
You leave the peaceful banks of the river behind you and continue on your way.
Shit upstream and hope he catches it.
On the banks of the Warder. Some of the village is built on stilts in the river. A wooden bridge spans the fast-flowing water. A huge wooden palisade has been erected to protect the village from attack. Your eyes roam the land on the other side of the river. You estimate that you will soon have completed half of the journey to Black Saddle, but you still can't make out the mountain on the horizon. The guards on the palisade are watching you. Their armor looks well cared for and well made. The smith who made them knew what he was doing. You conclude that the men depend on the protection the armor offers and aren't just wearing them to look good.
But they do look good.
They're not villagers.
Oh, we're going somewhere. Gonna kill all the humans too. Oh. Got a bonfire, nice.
There are small fires burning every 50 steps or so. They are intended to light up the area in front of the palisade in the night, so that orcs can't creep up to within an arrow's reach without being seen.
You get shot immediately.
The double gate is made of strong planks, sturdy but still much less solid than the fixed parts of the palisade. Security has been foregone here for practical reasons. Never a good idea when building fortifications.
Orc skulls?
You're not sure it's wise to taunt the beasts with the severed heads of their fellow kind. Some of the guards begin to whisper as you near the gate.
Hello up there! What brings you to fair good water? And have you seen any orcs on your travels, groundling?
The man leaning over the palisade eyes you up and down carefully.
Ooh, he's giving me the eyes. Please let me in. I don't want to spend the night under the stars.
Good water is well known for its hospitality.
A fact that you've just made up yourself.
Let me in, and I will tell other travelers all about it.
I regret to inform you that we cannot allow you to enter. The gates stay closed once night has fallen.
There is certainly no regret showing in the man's face.
Aww. Gate doesn't look like it's a very stable impression. I took a look at it. I know about these things.
I'm a blacksmith. And a dwarf. Let me tell you, your gate might look solid, but it won't withstand a real orc assault.
The murmuring all around him makes the man pause for a moment. If anyone else had criticized the stronghold, they'd have been laughed down and shooed away. But no one understands defense systems like the dwarves.
A dwarf blacksmith who just happens to be standing in front of our gate?
Of course, I'm responsible for the defense of the High Pass and the Blue Range, derp.
That's right. I can see to it that orcs crack open their skulls on your gate, just like at home on the High Pass. Skulls that add up to hard cash for you.
You only know about the Secondling Stronghold from books, but you can see in the man's face you've pushed the right buttons.
All right, then. You can spend the night in the village. You begin work tomorrow morning, and in a better world like you promised.
Of course. It's a trifle.
You fail immediately. And get shanked in your sleep.
After a meal, you spend the night in the comfort and shelter of a good water tavern. The next morning, you feel fully refreshed. You strengthen the gate with cross braces of wood and iron, using your experience and skill. Now it should be able to withstand an attack for much longer. Mercenaries and villagers alike watch you work, clearly impressed. As you finish, a man approaches you.
Well done, dwarf. We were right to bring you into our village.
The village grew rich through bridge tolls, and this wealth must be defended.
Oh. Payment. No, they gave me a place to stay.
You're proud of what you've achieved in such a short time. You've even invested more time than was wise.
I was happy to help. But half the day is lost, and I must be on my way.
A strong dwarf like you will always be welcome here in Goodwater. Be careful out there. Who knows where the orcs might be lurking?
Nice!
An uneasy feeling has been your constant companion since you left Goodwater. Every little sound in the forest makes you fear you've been discovered by a horde of orcs. But you reach the end of the day without bumping into any of the greenskins. It seems as though Vrakus has granted you one more day in Girdleguard. As night begins to fall, you pass a large oak tree and decide to call it a day. Near the oak tree is an abandoned camp with a fireplace, which appears to be a couple of days old.
Set up camp hidden in the crown of the old oak tree.
You swing yourself up the trunk and then pull up your baggage after you. You're prepared to sleep in a tree like a bird if it means escaping the orcs' attentions. You sling your rope twice around your stomach and the trunk of the tree to stop you from falling accidentally. You close your eyes and dream.
Of
you see
Nord women.
Pass and smell the fresh, icy wind that sweeps over the peaks of Great Blade and Dragon's Tongue. But the harmony is interrupted by the hideous roar of an unending flood of orcs throwing itself unceasingly against the fortification. You smell the disgusting green blood of the orcs and taste the rancid fat of their armor on your tongue. The bitter
Why
taste
is he licking their armor?
Until it's unbearable and wrenches you out of your dream. You open your eyes and are surprised at the brightness as a glance at the sky confirms that it's still night. Your eyes move towards the ground, and what you see makes the blood in your veins freeze.
Oh my god. An orc orgy. Orc-gy.
Oh, good thing we camped in the tree.
I am Synthras of Son Balsur. My master, Nod On the Doublefold, ruler of the Perished Land, has elected you, the Lords of Taboribor, to be the sword that conquers the south.
You mean you want us to put our necks on the line and be killed by some magus?
Lord Yonan and the others will be taken care of. Your task is to create a diversion in the south until my master's plan succeeds.
And which of us is the leader?
The one that conquers the most land.
So Kragnar will be the new Grand Lord.
He glares at Ushnot's.
A lot of voice acting is pretty good.
Kragnar's shore tribe will conquer the most land.
Never! We will overwhelm the cities of the Red Bloods quicker than you can suck the marrow from a bone.
And he's really good at sucking from a bone.
You can't believe what you're hearing. If the beasts of Teon ride into battle together, catastrophic cycles lie ahead for Girdleguard.
Gaining AP.
The night in the oak tree was the worst of your life. You spent every single moment afraid that you'd be found and savaged by the orcs.
And savaged.
But as the first rays of sun broke through the treetops, the orcs abandoned their camp and left without discovering you.
Let's observe it just a little longer.
Better safe than sorry.
Your eyes scan the deserted camp, and you listen carefully for any noise. But you don't see or hear anything suspicious.
All right. That's a long sausage you got in your pocket. Nice. What do we got around here? We've got example of a pile of rubbish.
The foul aftermath of the orc's presence.
You don't feel any urge to stick your nose too deeply into the mixture of ripped clothes.
Oh, come on.
Leftover food.
Sniff them.
And feces.
Sniff those feces.
I knew it was here. Come on, then. Find that stupid necklace.
Excuse me? Necklace?
Hey, Fuska! In front of you! A grounding! Perfect for a spotted breakfast.
Throw your axe at the leader and try to escape.
You know that you're no warrior, but perhaps you can escape with a diversion.
Oh, wrecked. Nope. We're dead, boys.
Oink, oink, little piggies!
My God, he's a badass. Dual wielding.
Arrow and spear. How did you manage to lose your weapon? Go and get it, and this time, hold it tight. Hey, that one was mine.
You're just too slow, dear brother.
Too slow? Just wait.
Oh my God. Yeah, party of three. Kill all the attackers. What is this? Talisman? Oh, right, right, right. Our talisman. I forgot about that. Well?
Huh?
He's got the jumps thing. This, he's got a blade storm. Multiple blows in front.
What is
okay.
It?
He's got a good chance of stunning. Eruption. Pushes all enemies back. Into knocking them down. All right, well, let's, what do we got here? We've got a good swath of dudes. Let's
say
go after that guy.
And what now?
I'll jump on these guys?
Yes.
Let's pop the trinket, I guess. Okay. It's got 15 seconds, it looks like, and then let's, crunch some dudes. Did you knock somebody down?
Huh?
I'll get over there and bash his butthole. Huh? What's wrong with you?
As good as done.
Yeah! Kind of wanted to get a group.
Oh, what bad luck for you!
Yeah, group up on me. Let's W this.
What is it?
Dun, 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 dun.
Huzzah!
I guess I'll do that. He's just gonna auto attack bitches. Okay, alright. So kill him.
And what now? Of course!
He's already dead, that guy. Kill
come
him.
Here, you.
Yes?
Kill him.
With pleasure. Too easy.
Nice.
Huh? What
after
is it?
Hather? I'll jump on these guys. Ah, sploop!
Yes, yes!
That guy was knocked down. We'll kill him.
Yes?
Yerp. Who else? Who else got knocked down? Did you get knocked down? What are you? What is even here?
For breakfast.
Smash a dude, suck a dude, let's suck a dude.
Now?
Yeah, oh yeah. Are you gonna kill this guy in one
huzzah!
Hit? You missed. There you go.
Come here, you.
I knocked myself down. Okay, that's terrible, getting knocked down. And I missed.
Huh?
Alright, don't land on my own dude. Note to self. Bad. It's very bad. This doesn't do any damage, does it? Nope, it just knocks downs and stuns.
Say goodbye forever.
I mean, it lets me one-shot a dude.
Pleasure. Say goodbye forever.
Or a couple of dudes at least, so it's not the worst.
And
what now?
Come yeah. Here, you. Huh? These archers are kind of crapping on my mouth.
For Vrakus! Understood. Attack!
Let's go kill these archers.
They only put up a
too
fight.
Easy!
Too easy!
Huh?
Look at me. I'm going to stomp on a dude's face. Yarr. They're like pirates, but not. W.
Oh my god, the flailing is real. Alright, he's pretty good. How you doing over here, buddy? You doing alright? You do a little W action? Oh my god, you just knocked everybody down. Kill them all with your man powers. Yeah, boy. Super worth just doing that over and over.
Say goodbye forever. Too easy.
Too easy.
You even have anybody over here? Just kill that guy. Nice. I think you hit your friend, though. That's not very good. Whoa, camera. Where? What? How do we?
At once. On my way.
I don't like that camera angle. No, sir. How come I can't, There we go.
For Vrakus!
For Vrakus, apparently. Oh, my God. All right, get over there. Just wrecked. Stomp on him?
Yes.
I like it.
End it. What is it?
How are you doing over here? You doing all right? Need some help? Need me to guide you?
Killed.
Stunned. All right. Do you kill them when they're stunned?
Forever.
No.
As good
you don't,
as done.
But, you know, good enough.
Pow! Another one bites the dust. On my way!
What's going on over here? Here's a little of this. why are you taking so much damage? What's wrong with you? Huh? You a weirdo? One-shotted. Wrecked him. What? 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 One dude.
Huzzah!
That, you looked the wrong way, sir.
Yes.
Huh? Say goodbye forever.
Knock down your friends? Yeah. Aww. Nice. We did it.
Oink oink. That's all? No more orcs? Well fought, young friend. Do you happen to be tongued ill?
Is that an orc head
well
rolling
fought,
around?
But he fought like a...
Boindeel, what do you expect? He grew up amongst the humans.
Who are you and how do you know my name?
My name is Boindeel Hookhand of the clan of the Swinging Axes. This is my brother, Boindeel Doubleblade. We've been sent to find you.
Wow.
Call me Ironheart. Are there any more?
They called him Doubleblade. His last name's Doubleblade, but that was when he was a child. He's just born into the Doubleblade clan, so he was forced to use double blades, even though he didn't want to. There are more orcs here than anyone could ever wish for.
There was a meeting last night. The Elfar serve a certain Nod On who calls himself Lord of the Perish Land. They have enlisted 3 orc hordes to cause unrest in the south.
Did you hear that, Boindeel? Piggy snouts!
The Elfar from Son Balzur and the orcs from Taborabor are working together.
That's a lot of words,
dude. And ally with the orcs from the Perish Land.
The twins look at you solemnly. You all know what that would mean for the people of Girdlegard.
We must help the humans.
We've got to... Yeah, I know what you're gonna say. But it's our duty to get you to the Ogre's Death Fortress in one piece.
Why would I want to go to a death
fortress? I thought the duty of dwarves was to protect the innocent in Girdlegard.
Lot Yonan and King Brauron will take care of the orcs. We three must be careful. You're not exactly a warrior.
But he has broad shoulders and broad hands.
Dude, don't look at my shoulders like that, you sicko.
So when you've got the chance to spit a few orc skulls,
that's what you're ramping up to.
You turned up at just the right moment. But are you sure it's me you're looking for?
The High King Gundrabor sent us to fetch you and bring you to Ogre's death in the Secondling realm in the south.
So he received the letter from my master? And am I a Secondling?
Well, something like that, I guess.
Is that jiggly head creep anybody else out?
Then my family was found and the High King wants to bring me back to my clan.
No, you're not a Secondling. You're a Fourthling. And you're to...
The High King will tell you all about that once we get to Ogre's death. We should get going.
I would be happy to follow you into the realm of the Secondlings. In truth, there is nothing I would rather do. But first, I must travel to Blacksaddle and return some things to a former famulus of Lot Yonan.
Blacksaddle isn't exactly on our way.
It's on my way. We can head south as soon as I've carried out Lot Yonan's orders.
Boom.
Well, he certainly got the stubbornness of a dwarf. Perhaps we'll be able to make a real dwarf of him on the way.
All right, we'll accompany you. The sooner we find that famulus, the quicker we can get back to the mountains.
I'll have to send Lot Yonan a message by carrier pigeon on the way.
I just realized I'm a ginger.
And if we happen
I'm
to
a red dwarf.
A couple of orcs.
space
I like
jokes.
You, but we'll have to find you another name.
Call me Boelenthor.
It's about as good as Lipsmith.
It looks like Boelenthor, but it's Boelen. I swear.
Senseless and definitely not a name of honor. What are you good at?
I'm good at reading.
Reading? You're a scholar?
Oh, and then we leveled up, apparently. Oh, yeah. Okay. All right. Oh, we get to choose. What do we got? We've got sweep an enemy off his feet or cleave. Let's cleave it up. Yeah, what do we got? We got a charge. We've got a jump. We've got 50% more damage with everything. We've got receive half damage. Deal 25% damage for a short extra time for everybody around me. Gain twice the AP when he kills enemies. That's pretty cool. Force of Tongue's actions and attacks is raised significantly for a short time. So basically just man mode. We got potions, we got talisman of healing, 10% chance to regenerate 10% health during a successful attack. Ooh, that could be cool for the dual wield guy because he hits a billion times. That must have been the talisman that those orcs were coming to the camp for. So let's see if I select this guy and say, use that. Nice. Okay, alright. Relationships? What? What is this? Orc horde? I mean, I like orc hordes. Another question. Wait, didn't we get a question mark here? It's the 9. Oh my god, so many things. But I think for now, we're gonna end it there. And I'll thank you guys for watching the dwarves. And, yeah. As always, we'll see you next time, and thanks for watching.